ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நமக சில்ட்ரன் வெல்கம் டு ஆன்லைன் டீச்சிங் அகாடமி ஏக்கலைவா. டுடே ஐம் கோயிங் டு டிஸ்கஸ் எக்ஸசைஸ் 7.10 க்வெஸ்சன் நம்பர் 3 இன்டெக்ரல் 0 டு 1 இன்டெக்ரல் 0 டு 1 சைன் இன்வர்ஸ் 2x divided by 1 plus x square into dx. Here you have to listen carefully, children. The given integrand we cannot integrate directly. We are going to use the trigonometry identity here. We are going to use the trigonometry identity. When you adapt trigonometry identity, that is substitution, the limit also will change. Once again, I repeat. When you adapt substitution, the limit also will change, right? Now, x is equal to tan theta. X is equal to tan theta. Then, what is the differentiation? Substitution means you want to do the differentiation only. I say dx equal to secant square theta into d theta. Dx by d theta equal to secant square theta d theta, I cross multiply. Now, when x is equal to 0, when x is equal to 0, what can you get? Theta is equal to, when x is equal to 0, theta is equal to 0. Theta is equal to 0. Because theta is equal to tan inverse x. Tan inverse 0 is also 0. When x is equal to 1, x is equal to 1, theta is equal to tan inverse 1, which is equal to pi by 4. Got it? Now, I equal to integral, limit you are going to change, right? What is the limit? 0 to pi by 4 sine inverse of 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. Dx can be replaced by what? Secant square theta into d theta. See the bracket, it what it represents? Sine 2 theta formula, right? Sine 2 theta equal to 2 tan theta divided by 1 plus tan square theta. You have to be thorough in trigonometry. Only you can do the sum, otherwise you feel tough, right? Now, it is equal to integral 0 to pi by 4 sine inverse of sine 2 theta to secant square theta d theta. Sine inverse of sine theta is nothing but theta. So you should, here 2 theta is there, your result is 2 theta. Sine inverse of sine theta equal to theta. If suppose you have 2 theta, your result will be 2 theta. 3 theta means 3 theta. Here we have 2 theta, so 2 you should take it as outside. Integral 0 to pi by 4 theta into secant square theta d theta. See, here 2 functions are there. You are going to apply integration by parts. Integration by part. Here we are going to consider theta as the first function. Theta as the first function means, what does it mean? You have to take u as theta. You have to consider u as theta. Integration by parts formula, u dv equal to uv minus integral v du. Right? Theta is the first function, I say. First function is always your u. U equal to theta. Du equal to d theta. The rest of the things I told you, integral dv. Integral dv equal to integral secant square theta d theta. What is integral secant square theta d theta? Any idea about that, children? Integral secant square theta d theta equal to tan theta. V equal to tan theta. Now I am going to move to the integration by parts formula. 2 into bracket u b. What is your u? U is theta. What is your v? Tan theta. So theta into tan theta minus limit, you have to substitute 0 to pi by 4. First part as integration, integrated. Now you come to the second part. Integral v du. Integral v is tan theta, du is d theta. 0 to pi by 4. 2 is common for both the things. That's why I use the square bracket. Now, which is equal to 2 into, you have to apply the limit here. Pi by 4 into tan pi by 4. Upper limit minus 0. Lower limit as over. Minus 2 into integral tan theta d theta. What is the integration of tan theta d theta? Tan theta d theta equal to minus log cos theta. Minus log cos theta. Right? Modulus. Now minus 2 into integral. When you integrate this, what can you get? Minus log of cos theta. 0 to pi by 4. Got it? Minus into minus plus. The next step you have to apply that. Into pi by 4 tan pi by 4. Tan pi by 4 value is 1. So 2 into pi by 4 into 1 minus into minus plus 2 into log of cos upper limit minus lower limit, right? Log of cos pi by 4 minus 2 into log of cos 0 upper limit minus lower limit. Here you have to see two cancel. The first part you arrive pi by 2 plus. Here what can you get? 1 by root 2. Log 45 degrees 1 by root 2. So 2 log 1 by root 2 minus 2 into cos 0, 1, log 1 value is 0, log 1 equal to 0, so it becomes vanished. Now, pi by 2, plus 2 into log of 2 power minus 1 by 2. Log of a power m can be written as m into log a. Already I discussed the result and all, right? Now what is the result now? Pi by 2 minus 2 into 1 by 2 log 2. Then 2 cancel. You arrive the result as pi by 2 minus log 2. Pi by 2 minus log 2. Now, what is your answer finally? I equal to pi by 2 minus log 2. Got it, children? Now, I am going to move to question number सिक्स। क्वेश्चन नंबर सिक्स, इंटीग्रल 0 to 2 1 डिवाइडेड बाय एक्स प्लस 4 माइनस एक्स स्क्वायर इनटू डीएक्स। हियर आल्सो द गिवन इंटीग्रेंड वी कैन नॉट इंटीग्रेट डायरेक्टली, सो वी आर गोइंग टू कन्वर्ट द डिनोमिनेटर इन टर्म्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म। व्हाट इज दैट स्टैंडर्ड फॉर्म? ए स्क्वायर प्लस एक्स स्क्वायर, a square plus x square or a square minus x square. When you convert into that, you can apply the formula, right? How I am going to change, how I am going to convert the denominator, you have to listen carefully. I equal to integral 0 to 2, I am going to apply the format, completing the square, right? X plus b by 2a the whole square minus b by 2a the whole square, right? What is your b here? B is your 1. What is your a? A is 1. A is minus 1, right? That you don't bother, you keep as such, right? Now 1 by x plus 4 minus x square dx equal to integral 0 to 2. How I am going to modify, you have to see. X plus b by 2a. Here what is your b? 1. What is your a? A is also 1. You have to keep it in that. So 1 by 2. Right? 1 by 2 the whole square means what can you get? 1 by 4. That means you have to add 1 by 4 and subtract 1 by 4. Add 1 by 4 and subtract 1 by 4. Now, x plus 4 minus x square. B is 1, a is 1. B is 1, a is 1. Like that you keep it in your mind. Then 1 by 4, that I am going to add and subtract. 1 by 2. The whole square my plus 1 by 2 the whole square. I added by 2a the whole square and subtract. What did x plus b by 2a the whole square minus b by 2a the whole square, completing the square, that you have to recall. Now how I am going to match it, that you have to listen. It is equal to integral 0 to 1. The constant alone I am going to take it separately, right? 4 plus 1 by 4 minus bracket x square minus x. Then minus is there, right? So it becomes plus 1 by 4. Got it, children? 1 divided by x minus x square minus 1 by 2 the whole square. That alone I am grouping. Minus, I took it as common. So I wrote x square. The plus it, x becomes minus x. The minus 1 by 2 the whole square, it becomes 1 by 4. Right? Suppose if your b is 2, then what it becomes? 2 by 2, 1. You should add and subtract 1. That is the concept, right? Now, what is the thing you will get here? We are going to convert into the standard format as 1 by a square plus or minus x square. What we are going to get, you have to see. Integral 0 to 2, 1 divided by 17 by 4 minus. It can be written as x minus 1 by 2 the whole square. X minus 1 by 2 the whole square. You have to expand and see whether will you arrive this or not. A square, x square, b square plus 1 by 4 minus 2ab minus 2 into x into 1 by 2. 2 to cancel minus x, right? Now, which is equal to integral 0 to 2, 1 divided by square root of 17 by 2, the whole square minus x minus 1 by 2, the whole square. Now I arrived at the standard format as 1 by a square minus x square, right? Now I can apply the formula. What is that formula? 1 by, that is integral dx divided by integral dx divided by a square minus x square equal to 1 by 2a into log of a plus x divided by a minus x. A plus x divided by a minus x. That formula I am going to apply here. I equal to integral 0 to 2. What is 1 divided by root of 17 by 2 the whole square minus x minus 1 by 2 the whole square into dx. What is your a? A equal to root 17 by 2. What is your x? X is equal to x minus 1 by 2. That you keep it in your mind, children. While using the formula, you have to be very careful. I equal to, the integration is over, right? 1 by 2 into root 17 by 2 log of modulus root 17 by 2 plus x minus 1 by 2 divided by root 17 by 2. Numerator a plus x, denominator a minus x, so minus x plus 1 by 2. Now we are going to apply the limit as 0 to 2. Limit as what? 0 to 2. First you have to simplify the format. 1 by root 17. 1 by root 17 log of root 17 plus 2x minus 1 divided by root 17 minus 2x plus 1. When you are going to apply the upper limit and the lower limit. What is the upper limit? What is the lower limit? You have to see. When you apply the upper limit, what can you get? When you apply the upper limit, that is 1 by root 17 log of modulus upper limit minus lower limit, right? First you should apply the upper limit. What can you get? Root 17 plus 3 divided by root 17 minus 3. Upper limit is over. That is, instead of x you are going to substitute 2. 2 2s are 4. 4 minus 1 3. Minus 4 plus 1 minus 3. Minus log of root 17 minus 1 divided by root 17 plus 1. When you substitute the lower limit as 0, you will arrive this portion as vanished, root 17 plus 1 in the denominator, root 17 minus 1 in the numerator. What is now? Log of division. Log A minus log B equal to log A by B. Got it? Log A minus log B इक्वल टू लॉग ऑफ ए बाय बी. नाउ 1 बाय रूट 17 इनटू लॉग ऑफ रूट 17 प्लस 3 डिवाइडेड बाय रूट 17 माइनस 3. Right, log a by b, I said, by root 17 minus 1 divided by root 17 plus 1. The root 17 plus 1 will move to the numerator. Root 17 minus 1 will come to the denominator, right? 1 by root 17 log of root 17 plus 3 into root 17 plus 1 divided by root 17 minus 3 into root 17 minus 1. What a difference? This is your A, this is your B. Now, which is equal to 1 by root 17 into root 17 into root 17, 17. 1 root 3 root 17, again, what can you get? 1 root 17, so I'm going to add and write 17 plus 3, that is 20. Log of 20 plus 4 root 17. See, root 17 into root 17, 17 plus 3 root 17 plus 1 root 17 plus 3. So 17 plus 3, 20. 3 root 17 plus 1 root 17 will give you 4 root 17 divided by 20 minus 4 root 17. What I, the same thing I applied in the denominator also. Now, 5 you can take it as common. Right? 4 you can take it as common. Root 17 log of 4 you should take it as common in both numerator and denominator. 5 plus root 17 divided by 5 minus root 17. Then 4 cancel. Then you have to take conjugate and multiply both numerator and denominator. It is equal to 1 by root 17 into log of modulus. See, log of modulus 5 plus root 17 whole square divided by 5 square minus root 17 the whole square. What I did here, I apply the conjugate. What is the conjugate of this? You have to take the conjugate of the denominator. 5 minus root 17 means 5 plus root 17. Use that and multiply both numerator and denominator. A into A, so A square. In the denominator, 5 minus root 17, 5 plus root 17. That can be written as A square minus B square. What I now, this is equal to 1 by root 17 into log of 25 plus 17 plus 10 root 17 divided by 25 minus 17 modulus. Sorry children, you have to use modulus. 1 minute. I can use the eraser and I erase it, right? Modulus. Log of now. 1 by root 17, I equal to 1 by root 17 log of, what it is, 25 plus 17, 42, right? 42 plus 10 root 17 divided by 8. Then 1 by root 17, you have to take 2 as common in both numerator and denominator. You will get it as 21 plus 5 root 17 divided by 8. Now, final result, what it is? I equal to 1 by root 17 log of modulus 21 plus 5 root 17 divided by 4. What is children? Modulus you have to put, you don't use the bracket, right? Better you have to use modulus, don't go for the bracket. Modulus. Once again, I'm going to teach you the concept again. Okay. The given integrand, we cannot integrate directly. So we apply b by 2a. What is your b? B is 1, a is also 1. So 1 by 2. You are adding 1 by 2 the whole square, that you are adding and subtracting. B by 2a you are adding and subtracting. Here your b by 2a is 1 by 2. So you are added 1 by 2 the whole square, subtract 1 by 2 the whole square. Then I modify the format. Constant I wrote it separately. That is 4 plus 1 by 4. Then x square minus, I took it as common, x square minus x plus 1 by 4. That it gives you the identity as x minus 1 the whole 1 by 2 the whole square. Now the given integrand, I said we cannot integrate directly. The denominator I converted in terms of standard form as a square minus x square. Integral dx divided by a square minus x square equal to 1 by 2a into log of a plus x divided by a minus x. Modulus, right? Now here your a is root 17 by 2, your x is x minus 1 by 2. Modulus a plus x, a minus x. Now I'm going to apply the upper limit and the lower limit. 1 minute, children. I want to put the modulus symbol here. Right. Want to put modulus, right? Modulus you have to use, children, to don't forget, right? Log of modulus then I apply the upper limit and the lower limit. I arrive root 17 plus 3 divided by root 17 minus 3 divided by root 17 minus 1 divided by root 17 plus 1. Log a minus log b equal to log a by b I applied in the second step. Then I multiplied root 17 into root 17, 17 plus 3 into 1. 3, 17 plus 3, 20, then 3 root 17 plus 1 root 17, I wrote it as 4 root 17. Finally, I took 4 as common in both numerator and denominator. I arrived the result as 5 root 17 divided by 5 minus root 17. Then I took the conjugate. Conjugate means you want to take the conjugate for the denominator only. What is your denominator? 5 root 17. So, conjugate means 5 plus root 17. 5 plus root 17 into 5 plus root 17. I wrote it as 5 plus root 17 the whole square. Denominator 5 minus root 17. 5 plus root 17 means 5 square. That is a square minus b square. Then I simplified. Finally, I arrived the result as 1 by root 17 log of 21 plus 5 root 17 divided by 4. That is your final answer. What is different? Whenever the integrand we cannot integrate directly, you have to think of whether we want to adopt substitution or we are going to convert the denominator in terms of standard form. Right? Standard form means you want to change it in terms of formula format. Right? Thank you, children.